Hello friends, and welcome to another video by Engineering Today. A few days back, we discussed how SpaceX bagged 40% of launches, costing $316 million for mission USS F-67 to become a long runner in the market of national security satellites in the USA. SpaceX has also become the first private spacecraft to successfully launch and land their Crew Dragon in the Gulf of Mexico. Following these events on the 13th of August, which was Thursday, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk took to Twitter to criticize SpaceX's biggest competitor, United Launch Alliance, saying, "Efficiently reusable rockets are all that matter for making life multiplanetary and space power. Because their rockets are not reusable, it will become obvious over time that ULA is a complete waste of taxpayer money." No one from SpaceX's leadership team was available to make any comment on the announcement regarding that contract. As per reports, SpaceX communication team was also not available to respond to any big media houses until Musk took to Twitter on Thursday to express his displeasure. And why not? Apart from SpaceX CEO's reaction, we have two more news for you. First, SpaceX's job posting for a resort development manager to develop the Boca Chica Village into a spaceport, and second, NASA's announcement regarding the revised date of SpaceX Crew 1's launch. Let's get into details. Since SpaceX started its journey, Elon Musk always targeted to reduce the cost of access to spacecrafts and also intended to expand U.S. military's authority. SpaceX has already proved their capability to reuse SpaceX Falcon 9 booster as many as 5 times. From the very beginning, SpaceX's vision has been revolving around producing reusability of spacecrafts. Elon Musk's criticism also highlights the same, the way a larger share of the contract were handed over to ULA instead of SpaceX's recent success of bringing back Demo 2 Crew Dragon, hence the outburst in the social media from SpaceX's CEO, was evident. Tim Fernholz, a reporter at Quartz, who publishes a weekly newsletter called Space Business. In the recent edition of this newsletter, he's made fun of the commercial rocket industry for its fuzziness and continuing an imprecise culture. Tim's mentioned much of this newsletter is sealed to protect the competitive secrets of SpaceX and the other bidders, but redacted filings give us a clue about what Musk and company are upset about. The following comments, which he associated with his newsletter, drew the attention of Musk. Knowing SpaceX CEO for reacting to Twitter provocations, Tim also said, "We found something Elon won't tweet about," and he got what he was looking for, headlines. Fernholz most probably wanted to capitalize on SpaceX's silence, even after bagging such a big contract. No reaction from any SpaceX's big shots were raising eyebrows and speculations about not meeting expectations as well. SpaceX might have opted not to react, as they're yet to receive any clarification regarding the criteria or process which allowed ULA to get away with 60% of the contract share. Another probable reason could be SpaceX's ongoing lawsuit with the US government as well. Though Tory Bruno, the CEO of United Launch Alliance, played safe in the entire episode, social media reactions, and simply replied to SpaceX's CEO indirectly by tweeting, "I congratulate SpaceX on their USAF NSS Phase 2 award." As per reports, ULA wished to launch reusable version of company's Vulcan rockets, but they've not set any specific goal or timeline so far. During all this, a job advertisement for SpaceX drew everyone's attention. They're willing to hire a resort development manager to develop the Boca Chica Village in Texas into a 21st century spaceport and the company's first resort. As per the job posting by SpaceX, the resort development manager will be responsible for supervising the development of a luxury spaceport in Texas from which humans will one day travel to Mars. Aiming to make this super fun. This is what SpaceX CEO tweeted after the job posting was published. "Design management, construction supervision, architecture, and managing the development of the resort till completion are the roles defined for the post. The manager would need to provide the final cost and schedule for the project and implement cost controls. The basic qualification required for this post is a bachelor's degree with 5+ years experience in construction project management. It would require the resort development manager to obtain all city, county, governmental approvals and coordinate all the field work, act in the capacity of a project superintendent, coordinating and confirming the project specifications with the user, and maintain the quality and workmanship of the project is also part of the job role. Having working experience for any high-end luxury brand development is a prerequisite as well. The facility will be catered by SpaceX's Starship spacecraft, which successfully completed test flight earlier this month. We all know Elon Musk has a dream to colonize Mars. He not only wants to see us there, but also wished to die there as well. In June, SpaceX CEO already expressed his concern that he might not be able to see humans making to Mars in his lifetime. So building Starship spacecraft is an utmost priority for his company. 49-year-old Elon Musk said at the Satellite 2020 conference in March, "The thing that concerns me most right now is that unless we improve our rate of innovation dramatically, there's no chance of a base on the moon or a city on Mars." He added, "This is my biggest concern. We've got to improve our rate of innovation, or, based on past trends, I am definitely going to be dead before Mars." As per SpaceX, though no dates are finalized yet, but as early as 2024, the early missions for Starship could get initiated. The humongous spaceship may transport human beings to the moon while catering many other locations in between. Traveling at hypersonic speed is also a possibility. In February 2020, there were statements from SpaceX which gave us some idea how the village spaceport may look like. SpaceX CEO hoped to initiate the process to convert the village of Boca Chica into the SpaceX Village, having an eye set on the Mars mission. He was willing to build a private spaceport, which may feature 100 rooms, facilities to arrange volleyball tournaments, kayaking and rock climbing activities, including lounge to host events or parties. But soon after the job advertisement was posted, SpaceX started facing resistance from the current residents from that village, as many of them are not willing to sell their houses at any cost, even not for many times market value. The residents are seeking legal help, as SpaceX wants to start the development of the village as soon as possible. This job posting made one thing pretty evident, that SpaceX is still committed to convert Boca Chica into a resort similar to what Virgin Galactic is establishing in the New Mexico desert. In our last video, we discussed about SpaceX's plans in the near future, which revolved around Crew 1. This spacecraft will be the first one used for full-length astronaut mission by SpaceX. It'll carry 4 crew members and a Crew Dragon capsule to spend 6 months on the International Space Station. On the 13th of August, NASA announced that Crew 1, which was planned to be launched no earlier than September this year, will be postponed to no earlier than October 23rd. SpaceX's Crew 2 mission is planned to launch in spring of next year, which may happen at the same time when Crew 1 is most likely to be docked. NASA's Mike Hopkins, Victor Glover, Shannon Walker, and JAXA's Soichi Noguchi will be the crew members for the Crew 1 mission. The capsule will be lifted by SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket, which arrived in Florida in July. As per NASA, the delay is mainly due to space traffic, as a Russian Soyuz spacecraft is set to launch to ISS in October. NASA astronauts Kate Rubins and cosmonauts Sergei Ryzhikov and Sergei Kudsverchkov are the crew members of the Russian Soyuz MS-17 craft. Following the success of SpaceX's Demo 2, Crew 1 will also make a huge impact on commercial spaceflight milestones. As per NASA, Crew 1 will enable the agency to regularly fly astronauts to the space station, ending sole reliance on Russia for space station access. Making it a historic week, SpaceX's employees were given a day off on Friday, officially titled Crew Mission Holiday. Such an eventful week, isn't it? That's what we had for you this time. Hope you liked it. Stay safe and take care. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.